فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
And the second hadith which the author is trying to use for this particular point is the hadith of Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the messenger said, إن أولى الناس بي المتقون حيث كانوا ومن كانوا. And Ahmad narrated it with Isnaduhu Hassan, that the people who are most closest to me, my allies, are the muttaqoon, the righteous people. حيث كانوا, wherever they are, ومن كانوا, and whoever they are. So the author is trying to use this as an evidence, because the one who innovates in Islam, even if he's from the Prophet's family, okay, فَقَدْ بَرِئَ مِنْهُ الرَّسُولُ, the Prophet freed himself from them. And the ones that the Messenger mentions that is his closest allies are who? They are the ones who are upon his path. The ones who are upon his path and his way, alayhi salatu wassalam. The fifth evidence which the author mentions is the hadith of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dhukira lahu anna ba'd an-nas anna ba'd as-sahabati qal. This hadith is in Muttafaq, is in Bukhari and Muslim. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a group of men came to the Prophet's house and they asked about his ibadah, and they were told that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sleeps, he eats, and he's married. And each and every one of them spoke. One said, "Amma ana fa aqumu wa la anam. I'm going to stand all night and I'm not going to pray. So and I'm not going to sleep. I'm going to pray all night and I'm not going to sleep." Another one said, "As for me, ana asumu wa la aftir. I'm going to fast. I'm never going to break my fast." Another one said, "Fala atazawwaju nisa. I'm never going to get married." Then the Messenger said to them all, "Lakini ana. As for I, anamu, I sleep. Wa aqumu, and I pray. Wa asumu, and I fast. Wa uftiru, and I break my fast. Wa atazawwaju nisa, and I marry women. Wa akulu lahma, and I eat meat. Faman raghiba an sunnati falaysa minni." Extreme exaggeration is what they came with. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, "Faman raghiba an sunnati falaysa minni. Anyone who leaves my path is not from amongst me." So the raghba from the sunnah comes in two ways: showing passion to other than the sunnah, in which the hadith is talking about, is one of two ways. One is al-i'radu anha ma'atiqad al-'abdi annama huwa 'alayhi akmalu hadyan min hadi ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That the person turns away that which the Messenger was upon, whilst believing what he is upon is better than that which the Messenger was upon, then this is disbelief. It makes the person leave the fold of Islam. The second one is the person shows passion to something other than that which the Messenger was upon based on interpretation. Based on what? Interpretation. They believe this is right by way of ta'wil, interpretation. It doesn't take the person out of the fold of Islam. It just makes the person be incorrect and wrong, and it makes the person an innovator. Now,
باب قول الله تعالى: فأقم مسافر الدين حنيفا فطرة الله التي فطر الناس عليها. وقوله تعالى: ووصى بها إبراهيم بنيه ويعقوب. وقوله تعالى: ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا. وعن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: إن لكل نبي ولاة من النبيين، وأنا ولي منهم أبي إبراهيم وخليل ربي. ثم قرأ: إن أولى الناس بإبراهيم للذين اتبعوا هذا النبي والذين آمنوا والله ولي المؤمنين. رواه الترمذي. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه مرفوعا: بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا كما بدأ، فطوبى للغرباء. رواه مسلم. وله عنه أيضا قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله لا ينظر إلى أجسامكم ولا إلى أموالكم، ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم. ولهما عن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم انا فرطكم على الحوض ولا يرفع عنا الي رجال من امتي حتى اذا اهويت لاناولهم اقتلجوني فاقول اي ربي اصحابي ويقال انك لا تدري ما احدث بعدك ولهما عن ابي هريره رضي الله عنه ان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وددت أن قد راينا اخواننا قالوا اولسنا اخوانك يا رسول الله قال انتم اصحابي واخواننا الذين لم ياتوا بعد قالوا كيف تعرف من لم يات بعد من امتك قال أرأيتم لو أن رجلاً له خيل بر محجلة بين ظهران خيل درم بهم ألا يعرف خيله؟ قالوا بلى قال فإنهم يأتون بر محجلين من الوضوء وأنا فرطهم على الحوض إلا ألا ليذادن رجال يوم القيامة عن حوضي كما يذادن البعير الضال أناديهم ألا هلم فيقال إنهم قد بدلوا بعدك فأقول سحقا سحقا وللبخاري بينما أنا قائم إذا زمرة حتى إذا عرفتهم عرفوني خرج رجل بيني وبينهم فقال هلم فقلت إلى أين قال إلى النار والله قلت ما شأنهم قال إنهم ارتدوا بعدك على أدبارهم القهقرة ثم إذا زمره فذكر مثله قال فلا أراه يخلص منهم إلا مثل همل النعم ولهما في حديث العباس فأقول كما قال العبد الصالح وكنت عليهم شهيدا ما دمت فيهم ولهما عنه مرفوعا ما من مولود يولد إلا على الفطرة فأبواه يهودونه أو يهودانه أو ينصرانه أو يمجسانه كما تنتج البهيمة بهيمة جمعاء هل تحسون فيها من جدعاء حتى تكونوا أنتم تجدعونها ثم قرأ أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه فطرة الله التي فطر الناس عليها متفق عليه وعن حذيفة رضي الله عنه قال كان الناس يسألون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الخير وأنا أسأله عن الشر وخافت أن يدركني فقلت يا رسول الله إنا كنا في الجاهلية وشر فجاءنا الله بهذا الخير فهل بعد هذا الخير من شر؟ قال نعم وقلت وهل بعد هذا الشر من خير؟ قال نعم وفيه دخل قلت وما دخلوا؟ قال قوم يستنون بغير سنتي ويهتدون بغير هدي تعرف منهم وتنكر قلت وهل بعد هذا الخير من شر؟ قال نعم فتنة عمياء ودعاة على أبواب جهنم من أجابهم إليها قذفوه فيها قلت يا رسول الله صفهم لنا قال قوم من جلدتنا ويتكلمون بألسنتنا فقلت يا رسول الله فما تأمرني إن أدركت ذلك قال تلزم جماعة المسلمين وإمامهم قلت فإن لم يكن لهم جماعة ولا إمام قال فأعتزل تلك الفرق كلها
فأعتزل
تلك الفرق كلها ولو أن تعض على أصل شجرة حتى يأتيك الموت وأنت على ذلك أخرجاه زاد مسلم ثم ماذا؟ قال ثم يخرج الدجال معه نهر ونار فمن وقع في ناره وجب أجره وحط عنه وزره
نعم
ومن وقع في نهره وجب وزره وحط أجره قلت ثم ماذا قال هي قيام الساعة
هي
هي قيام الساعة. وقال أبو العالية: تعلموا الإسلام فإذا تعلمتموه فلا ترغبوا عنه، وعليكم بالصراط المستقيم فإنه الإسلام، ولا تنحرفوا عن الصراط شمالا ولا يمينا، وعليكم بسنة نبيكم وإياكم وهذه الأهواء. تأمل كلام أبي عالية، تأمل كلام أبي العالية، هذا ما أجل. وعرف زمانه الذي يحذر فيه من الأهواء التي من اتبعها فقد راغب عن الإسلام وتفسير الإسلام بالسنة، وخوفه عن أعلام التابعين على أعلام التابعين وعلمائهم من الخروج عن الإسلام والسنة. يتبين لك معنى قوله تعالى: إذ قال له ربه أسلم، وقوله تعالى: ووصى بها إبراهيم بنيه ويعقوب، وقوله تعالى: ومن يرغب عن ملة إبراهيم إلا من سفه نفسه، وأشباه هذه الأصول الكبار التي هي أصل الأصول، والناس عنها في غفلة. وبمعرفة هذا يتبين لك معنى الأحاديث في هذا الباب وأمثالها. وأما الإنسان الذي يقرأها وأشباهها وهو آمن مطمئن أنها لا تناله، ويظنها في ناس كانوا فبانوا آمنا مكر الله، فلا يأمن مكر الله إلا القوم القاسرون. وعن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال: خط لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خطا، ثم قال: هذا سبيل الله، ثم خط خطوطا عن يمينه وعن شماله، ثم قال: هذه سبل، على كل سبيل منها شيطان يدعو إليه، وقرأ أن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله. رواه الإمام أحمد والنسائي.
The author, rahimahullah, in this chapter, he's talking about al-amr bil istiqama, to be steadfast and upright upon Islam, to be firm upon Islam, and that Islam is the religion of fitrah. And he's warning against innovation because it changes the person and it makes the person deviate and become corrupt. Then the author, rahimahullah, he brought 14 evidences. He brought 14 evidences to back up this point that he's putting forward. And the first evidence which he brought is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala: فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا. And the way that the author is trying to use this verse is that the ayah is commanding us to uphold to Islam, face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our hearts. And that Islam is the religion which is what? Hanifan. Hanifan means ad-din al-mustaqim, the straight path. It's the religion that's in accordance to the person's basic instincts. And innovation, brothers and sisters, tunafi Islam. Innovation is an opposition to the Islam which a person needs to face Allah with. Innovation means you don't face Allah the way you should. You don't direct yourself to Allah the way you should. It means that you half-heartedly face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the rest of your heart is directed at your own whims and desires and what you want. Then the author brings a second evidence. قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, the statement of Allah, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ, where Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he gives a farewell to his children. Ya'qub alayhi salatu wasalam, also بِلُزُومِ الْإِسْلَام, to hold on to Islam حَتَّى الْمَوْتِ, until death comes to you, because it's the religion of the messenger. And anyone who shows passion to a religion other than it, he then falls into something which is against that which Nabiullah Ibrahim advised him to come with. And it becomes a path that which Allah is not pleased with. Bid'ah, innovation in the religion, it is opposing what Ibrahim told you to hold on to. The third evidence which the author, rahimahullah, brings is ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا. Allah says to the messenger, ثم أوحينا, we have sent revelation on you, أن اتبع, follow ملة إبراهيم حنيفا, the religion of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. And the author here, رحمه الله, is trying to use this by following Ibrahim في حنيفيته المتضمنة الإقبال على الله. حنيفية of Ibrahim, which consists of facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innovation, my beloved brothers and sisters, is turning away from Allah. It means not to face Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means التدين له بما شرع. It is to take a religion what He legislated subhanahu wa ta'ala. والانفكاك عن البدع. And it's to be distant from innovation. Because bid'ah خارجة عن الحنيفية. Bid'ah is far from Hanifiyya. Because bid'ah is from the imla'u al-ahwa'i wal-ara'. It is from the dictation that is dictated by your desires. It's not what is set by the religion. The fourth evidence which the author brings is إِنَّ لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ وُلَاتًا. Every prophet has an ally. مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that my wali is Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. This hadith Tirmidhi narrated it wa fi sanadihi da'fun. There's weakness in this chain of narration. But again, this hadith, the reason why the messenger said it in this hadith, according to those who see it to be authentic, is Ibrahim was a person mahdhul iqbali ala Allah. His religion was built upon pure essence of facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to worship Allah bima shara'a, that which Allah legislated. La bil ahwa'i wal bid'a. Ibrahim never worshipped Allah based on desires, and he didn't worship Allah based on innovation. The fifth evidence that the author brings is the hadith of Abi Huraira, marfu'an, bada al-islamu ghariban. Islam started off strange, and it will go back to being strange. Muslim narrated this hadith. And the author is trying to use this hadith as the strangeness of Islam is at the beginning when it started, and it's also going to be strange until the ending of time. And the reason why it's going to be strange is because people are going to be distanced from the essence of what Islam is. People are going to be inclined to their own whims and desires. And so the person who then comes and becomes steadfast upon the religion and leaves off innovation, then he becomes ghareeb, strange. And the innovation becomes the mainstream. The sunnah becomes the strange thing, the awkward thing that people look at. And the messenger said, فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَاء. Glad tidings for the strangers. The reason is because it's going to be hard for them to hold on to their religion. It is hard. Everything is attacking them. The media is attacking them. The Muslims themselves are attacking them. They're called different names. So wherever they go, they feel very tight. They're looked at. So holding on to their religion is becoming very hard for them. That's why the messenger said, يَأْتِي عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٌ. There's going to come a time to the people, Muslims. أَلْمُتَمَسِّكُ بِدِينِهِ كَالْقَابِضُ عَلَى الْجَمْرَةِ. That the one who's holding on to his religion is like he's holding on to hot charcoal. You need to hold on to the charcoal, but you can't, it's burning you. But you need to. It's like that. You're holding onto your religion, which you have to, but you can't, it's burning you. So some people will throw it, and others will just take the pain and hold onto their religion. Oh Allah, make us from those who hold onto their religion and not let go. Then the sixth evidence that the author brings is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنظُرُ إِلَىٰ أَجْسَامِكُمْ. Allah does not look at your bodies. Allah doesn't look how big a person looks. Allah doesn't look how strong you are. Allah doesn't look at the one who spent time in the gym and the one that didn't. That's not what Allah looks at. But rather what Allah looks at is the person's heart and the actions that manifest from the person. And that's exactly what Islam is about. Islam is about the relationship between what's in the heart and the relationship between what's on your limbs. And they both have to be sanctioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not allowed to have in your heart and keep in your heart that which Allah hasn't sanctioned. You're a slave of His. He created you, He brought you into this world. He's the one whose laws, rules and regulations should be in your heart. And then that is what should manifest on your limbs. So that's what Allah looks at. Allah looks at your heart and Allah looks at your actions. And that is the reality of steadfastness, istiqamah. And istiqamah means the opposite of innovation. So you free yourself from innovation and you free yourself from desires. So what is the action that the person does have to have? Allah is looking at your heart and He's looking at your what? Action. What is it that the action of the person has to be done with? Because what is it, the action that Allah is going to accept? The action that is tawheedul ibadah. It singles Allah in worship. And the action that comes with what? Tawheedul ittiba'. Singles the messenger in following. The person who comes with those two is the action which Allah looks at and accepts. The seventh evidence that the author brings is that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَنَا فَرَضُكُمْ عَلَى الْحَوْضِ مَا مَعْنَا أَنَا فَرَضُكُمْ فَرَضُكُمْ means أَنَا سَابِقُكُمْ I'm before you. I will be there at the hawd before you. Before you guys come, I will already be there. The messenger saying this, عليه الصلاة والسلام. So the Prophet would make it to the hawd before us. And when he comes, he says, وَلَيُرْفَعَنَّ إِلَيَّ رِجَالٌ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي A people from my ummah will be raised to me. They will be brought to me. حتى إذا أهويت لأناولهم and I then get close to grab them and to bring them closer, then اختلجوا دوني then they are taken away from me. They are removed from me. They are taken away from me. And then I say, أي ربي my Lord, my followers, my own ummah, فيقال it would then be said to me, إنك لا تدري you do not know Muhammad ما أحدثوا بعدك the things that they innovated after you. The things that they added onto your religion. And so then they get prevented from drinking from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hawd, his fountain. شَرْبَةٍ هَنِيئَةً لَا نَضْمَعُ بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا A thirst that would have those people will have to drink from that water that they will never be thirsty ever again. They are prevented from it. What was the reason? It will be said to the Prophet, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحَدَثُ بَعْدَكَ The people of innovation, all of them are مبدلون محدثون as Ibn Battal mentions in his Sharh of Sahih al-Bukhari that every innovator is a distorter and he is a person who adds onto the religion the Ahlul Bid'ah, that's what they are so they are prevented from having to drink from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hawd they are not allowed and this is su'ul aqibah this is an evil ending for them The eighth evidence that the author brings is the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Waditu, I wish, Anna qad ra'ayna ikhwanana, I wish that we saw our brothers. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, I wish, Anna qad ra'ayna ikhwanana, that I saw my brothers or we saw our brothers. The companions then they said, Awalasna ikhwanaka ya Rasulallah. O Messenger of Allah, are we not your brothers? Then the Messenger said, "Antum ashabi, you are my companions. Wa ikhwanuna alladhina lam yatu ba'du. My brothers are those who have yet not come." Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said to him, "Kayfa ta'rifu man lam yati ba'du min ummatik? How are you going to recognize these people who you have not seen? And they haven't yet come. How are you going to recognize them?" Then the messenger said, أَرَأَيْتُمْ Do you not see? لَوْ أَنَّ رَجُلًا لَهُ خَيْلٌ غُرٌ مُحَجَّلَةٌ بَيْنَ ظَهَرَانَيْ خَيْلٍ دُهْمٍ بُهْمٍ If a man was to have horses, and those horses, they had hooves, and they were white from the hooves, and on the face, they were like that. In the middle of horses, which are one color, could he tell the difference between which horse is which? They said, yes. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the ones who are going to be shining and whose body parts they will recognize is those who used to do wudu, who will come, فَإِنَّهُمْ يَأْتُونَ غُرًّا مُحَجَّلِينَ مِنْ أَثَارِ الْوُضُوءِ They're going to come shining from the places where they used to do wudu. وَأَنَا فَرَطُهُمْ عَلَى الْحَوْضِ And I am going to be there at the fountain before them. أَلَّا The Prophet said, Oh people, لَيُذَادَّنَّ رِجَالٌ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ A people will be diverted from my hawd, pushed away from my fountain, and hawdi كَمَا يُذَادُّ الْبَعِيرُ الضَّالُ Just like a riding beast that is going to a land that's not its, land, and the person who owns it is pushing them away, shushing them away. That's what's going to happen to those people. They're going to be shushed away and taken away from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam's fountain. Unadihim, the Messenger then says, I call out, Ala halumma, O people, come. Fayuqalu, it would then be said to me, Innahum them, qad baddalu ba'dak, they changed after you. They were not upon what you used to be upon. They were not upon what your companions were upon. فَأَقُولُ I would then say, سُحْقًا سُحْقًا Distance them from me then. Carry on distancing them from me. Don't let them come close. So this is a uquba. It's a punishment from Allah that a person is taken away from drinking from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's fountain, alayhi salatu wasalam. Oh Allah, don't prevent us. And don't stop us from being from those who drink from your fountain the day of judgment. This hadith, the Shaykh rahimahullah uses it for two evidences. The first one is fadilatul istiqamati ala al-islam, the virtue of being steadfast upon Islam. And that person, my beloved brothers and sisters, who is steadfast, istihqaqul ukhuwa, you deserve to be the Prophet's brother. That title is what's given to you by the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. So the person who is steadfast upon the religion and did not meet the Messenger, enough for you is that you need to know that the Messenger referred to you as a brother. You didn't get the rights to be a companion, but by holding on to his path, by sticking to his sunnah, you've earned the title of being the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam's brother. The second way that the author is trying to use this is what? سُوءُ الْعَاقِبَةِ الْإِحْدَاثِ بِالْمَنْعِ عَنِ الْحَوْضِ, the evil ending for the one who innovates by being prevented from drinking from the fountain. Because the one who innovates and changes the religion, مُنِعَ الْوُرُودِ, he's prevented from going down to the fountain of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Messenger says, سُحْقًا سُحْقًا, distance from them from me, and let destruction be for them. لَحِقَهُمُ الْهَلَاكُ وَالْبَوَارِ, evil and destruction has taken place for those people. The ninth evidence is the hadith of the Messenger, بَيْنَمَا أَنَا قَائِمٌ, whilst I was standing, إِذْ زُمْرَةٌ, a group. The hadith is narrated by Bukhari من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه. And the author is trying to use from it what he used from the previous hadith, which is سُوءُ عَاقِبَةِ, the evil ending of the what? The al-ihdath, innovating in the religion. The tenth evidence that the author uses is Hadith ibn Abbas, which is in Bukhari and Muslim. فَأَقُولُ I would then say, كَمَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الصَّالِحِ, like the righteous slave said. Al-Hadith, this is narrated by what? Bukhari and Muslim. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he will free himself that day from the ones who innovated and changed the religion. And the Abdul Salih here is Isa ibn Maryam. As some of the narrations in Sahih al-Bukhari clearly stated that it is Isa ibn Maryam. And the ayah is talking about what Isa ibn Maryam said. Because he's the one who says the day of judgment, he's the one who says, وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ. It's Isa ibn Maryam who conveyed his message to his people, but they chose to go against him. So the Messenger says, oh Allah, I free myself from them. The 11th evidence is Hadith Abu Hurairah, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is in Bukhari and Muslim, مَا مِن مَوْلُودٍ, there is no child born except يُولَدُ إِلَّا عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ, is born upon the natural disposition. And what the author means by that is everybody is born upon what? Al-Islamu al-Khalisu min al-Shawbi. Everybody who is born upon the Islam that is clean and cleansed. Changing and innovation is not what the person is born on. The person is born upon purity and clear submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The 12th evidence is the hadith of Hudhayfa radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that he said, كَانَ النَّاسُ يَسْأَلُونَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلِي الْخَيْرِ, that the people, they used to ask the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about khair, and I asked him about evil. And the way that the author is trying to use this hadith is from two different angles. The first one is, the hadith states, min wuqu' al-ihdath wa al-tabdil, innovation and distortion of the religion is going to happen. The second one is, wasiyatu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Messenger advises Hudhayfa bil istiqamati wa thabati ala al-islam, to be steadfast, to be upright upon Islam, biluzumi jama'ati al-muslimina wa imamihim, by sticking to the haqq and the Muslim leader. And if there is no group that day, and there's no leader that day, then the Messenger said to him, free yourself from all of the groups that there are. Don't associate yourself to any of the groups. فَاعْتَزِلِ الْفِرَقَ كُلَّهَا وَلَوْ أَنْتَ عَضَّ بِأَصْلِ شَجَرَةٍ حَتَّى يُدْرِكَكَ الْمَوْتُ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. And hold on to the asal. The asal here means that which the Messenger and his companions were upon. Hold on to that until death comes to you. Don't associate yourself to a group just because there is no haqq or no jama'ah, and say that these are the lesser of the two groups, or the lessest of evil. Free yourself from all of them, and just stick to the haqq and the truth that there is that day. Hold on to the roots, and the root is al-kitab was-sunnah bima alayhi salafu salih, and that which the pious predecessors were upon. The 13th evidence that the author mentions is the statement of Abi Aliyah al-Riyahi rahimahullah, ahad al-tabi'een, that he said, ta'allamu al-Islam, know Islam, and فَإِذَا تَعَلَّمْتُمُوهُ, if you learn Islam, فَلَا تَرْغَبُوا عَنْهُ, don't show passion to other than it. وَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالصِّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, be upon the straight path. فَإِنَّهُ الْإِسْلَامِ, the straight path is what Islam is. وَلَا تَنْحَرِفُ عَنِ الصِّرَاطِ, don't deviate and don't go astray from the straight path. شِمَالًا وَلَا يَمِينًا, don't go against the straight path, right or left. وَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ نَبِيِّكُمْ, upon you is the sunnah of your messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَهَذِهِ الْأَهْوَاءِ, be very cautious of the desires that will be at that particular time. And then the author says, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, تَأَمَّلْ كَلَامَ أَبِي الْعَالِيَ, observe and look at the kalam of Abi Aliya, how he's advising you. ما أجله, what is more greater than what he's telling you. وعرف زمانه, and remember the time of Abi Aliya. It's not the time today where the innovation has become the mainstream, which is gone even worse. يحذر فيه من الأهواء, Abu Aliya is warning against desires, a warning against innovation. And today it's become an insulting thing to say to the person, when you talk about innovation, people say, is that all you know? Is that all you talk about? They used to send each other letters, and this is one of the things that they would warn against each other. Stay away from desires. Stay away from innovation. Hold onto your religion wholeheartedly. And the fourth evidence that the Shaykh rahimahullah brings is Hadith ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud's hadith. خَطَّ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ خَطَّ. The Messenger made a path on the ground. He took a twig and he made a road on the floor. This is teaching them visually. The Prophet went to this extent to physically show the people. He took a twig and he made a line on the ground. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, this is Allah's path. This is who? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, هذا سبيل الله. This is Allah's path. Then the Messenger done paths on the left and paths on the right. خُطُوطًا عَنْ يَمِينِ وَخُطُوطًا عَنْ شِمَالِ, some on the right and some on the left. And then the Prophet said, هَذِهِ السُّبُلْ, these are paths. Not path, paths. Many. عَلَى كُلِّ سَبِيلٍ, each and every one of those paths on the right and the left. شَيْطَانٌ, there's a shaytan. يَدْعُوا إِلَيْهَا, calling the people to it. And then the Messenger recited the ayah, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيبًا, and this is my path, my straight path. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ, follow it. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلُ, and don't follow those paths. what's going to happen? فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِ. It will deviate you from that straight path. It will take you to هَاوِيَة. It will take you to destruction and the hellfire. And the shaytan are two types. Shaytan, which is shayateen jinniya, jinn shayateen, which you can't see them. And the other ones are shayateen insiya, human. Both of them are shayateen. The ones who come to you, who call you to innovation and beautify innovation from you, stay away from them. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوا وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا الصُّبُلْ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِي. Those people who are calling to those paths, stay away from it. Stay away from it and don't give no attention to it. They can be high in number if they want. They can be large in quantity if they want. أَنْتَ الْجَمَعَ وَإِن كُنْتَ وَحَدَكَ. You are the jama'ah even if you're by yourself and you're alone. وَإِيَّاكَ وَآرَاءِ الرِّجَالِ. And stay away from the statements and the opinions of people. وَإِن زَخْرَفُوهُ لَكَ بِالْقَوْلِ. Even if they beautify it for you and they are eloquent and soft-spoken and they are silver-tongued, don't be confused by that. Follow the haqq wherever you find it. And don't take it from the shayateen who call you to it. Naam.